some rappers pay my bills. All up on TV, I thought it made me richer. Wasn't paying me enough, I needed something quicker. So now I'm all in Nico basement, putting working on the phones. Either that or drive the money mark to make the pickups. Man, it's 2008, I'm trying to paint the picture. Comeback season in the works and now I'm thinking bigger. I got 40 in the studio, every night, late night. Gotta watch it, don't wanna make them sicker. That's my oh lord, got a whole lot to show for it. I mean, we could really get it, we could go for it. I'm just here for the Bucks and the Billies. Don't make me one of the ghosts for it. I run it, they like go for us. Run for us, run for us, go for us. Yeah, I mean, y'all already wrote for us. What's one more quote for us? Oh lord, who else sounding like this? They ain't made me what I am, they just found me like this. I was ready, I been ready since my dad used to tell me he would come into the house to get me. He ain't show up. Valuable lesson, man, I had to grow up. That's why I never ask for help. I do it for you. They do it real quick.
Welcome to a special presentation of the NBA on Christmas Day here on 2K Sports. We want to wish each and every one of you a Merry Christmas. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg and our sideline reporter. Burke. Eastern Conference battles always fun. This time it's the Cleveland Cavaliers intent on protecting home court. Victory eluded them last time in Chicago when they faced the Bulls.
Yeah, it's just hard to make up when you have an inability to make free throws consistently, and that's why they ended up losing.
Yes, sir. I think some doubt started to creep in when they kept missing those foul shots. I mean, you could see them start to shy away from wanting to even go to the line.
Now let's take a look at the Bulls opening lineup. Gibson is the four with Gasol at the five. Rose is the one with Butler as the two. And it's Mirotic in at the three. Timeout is called, first of the game for the Cavaliers. They are coming into this having notched a win against the Knicks in their last game.
I think everyone who saw that game would just have to agree was about what they could do defensively in terms of winning.
And I thought the activity was tremendous all over the court defensively. And that kind of hustle is going to pay off for you, and it also is going to keep your coach happy.
Rose with the ball. Now Smith defending.
And Kevin, who says a point guard should look to pass first? I mean, not when you can finish like this guy.
Well, Clark, he wasn't going to give that opportunity up to a teammate.
Well, you know, Kevin, that's one he'll always take himself, and he should. I mean, you can't pass up that kind of opportunity or fun.
And the first one at the line is good.
And it's strange to think that early last year, all the talk in the media was about the in-house fighting on the Cavs. Goes to show just how much better things are for a team when they're winning.
And Gibson, here we go.
Elevates and powers in the one-handed.
Ah, textbook.
Yeah, and I'm glad, guys, he doesn't go overboard on that one and get a little too fancy.
The kick out to Irving. Yes, and it's LeBron picking up the assist. Irving's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. Here's Rose. That's basket number two with his third shot off to a fast 2-for-3.
Really aggressive play there, taking it to the rack against the big fella.
You know, Greg, aggressiveness is really the only option when you're on the wrong side of the size equation.
The Bulls have gotten 4 of 6 field goal attempts to drop in the first quarter. Out to the wing. Here's Mirotic. Smith with the defensive effort.
Just tentative in the paint, lacking a little bit of confidence, allowed the defender to recover and contest that shot.
In transition, here come the Bulls. Oh, and the jam by Rose.
And it doesn't really matter who starts the break with how he runs the floor. He seems to always be the one who finishes.
Yeah, he is so fun to watch and how he attacks the rim at full speed like that, man. It's something to behold the way that guy gets to the rim.
Butler passes to Rose. They get a hand on it. Back to Butler. Releases. Gets to the corner and buries it.
I tell you what, fellas, we're seeing some really good ball movement out there.
Definitely. 10 of their last 12 points have come off assists.
And here's Love from the arc. Comes out of the gate empty. He's 0 for 1.
I tell you what, he has quite the act to follow. But Fred Hoiberg was a quick choice for the brass in Chicago. Signed that 5-year deal over the summer. Was easily one of the most in-demand coaches available.
They double team Love. Back to Smith. Just 5 to shoot. Irving kicks to Smith. Looking to end the drought. No good. And Chicago will go the other way with the ball. Well, Greg, for Hoiberg, it's his first job as an NBA head coach. Now, we know he played. He's been a part of an NBA front office.
Mm-hmm.
Clark, he came from Iowa State, where he honed his coaching skills and was highly respected.
Yeah, very much respected, particularly as an offensive coach. And we know the Bulls are pretty solid defensively, and he'll be looking to ramp up that offensive approach for that team, and I think he will.
Jimmy Butler.
And the lead just grows on that ridiculous offensive sequence.
You know, Clark, that dunk alone would have been spectacular. Never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop.
Yeah, that just added more to it.
And you know, guys, right now they're starting to flatline, just hanging on here for dear life.
And the Cavaliers call time here.
You know, he just, like every other coach, can't stand when the defense gives up points on the inside. And boy, are they struggling in there.
Yeah, well, they're getting pummeled in there. So you've got to figure out a way to make some adjustments to try to change that around. And that's why he needed the timeout.
Thompson, he's checked in for the Cavaliers. Shumper comes in for Kevin Love. So Chicago going with an almost entirely new group. Portis, he's checked in for Gibson. McDermott comes in for Miritich. Kirk Heinrich, he's checked in for Butler. And Brooks subbed in for Rose. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Really, the right play defensively. If you can't block, force them to the line.
Yeah, exactly. Prevent the layup. Just give them a little bump, and then maybe they'll think twice about coming into the lane next time. And if they don't think about it, at least they might be distracted by your presence.
And there's Shumpert. That's good on the assist by Irving. Shumpert's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball.
Oh, wow.
That's an Irving Shumpert slam.
That's a beautiful jam.
That is such good work to make this a one-possession game. Terrific steal to get it all started.
And it's one thing to get the steal, but to so alertly turn it into a transition opportunity, even better.
Irving for 3. 1 quarter in the books, and it's been a close one so far.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Cavalier Girls.
And we're ready to get rolling once again here for a Christmas Day matchup. And taking a look at Chicago's performance here, guys, what have they been doing or not doing?
You know, they're not going to sit back and just take jump shots. It's all about attacking the paint and getting to the rim.
That's who they are. They've been the aggressor early, attacking the hoop and getting into that paint.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, as the second quarter gets going. So the Bulls 5 right now. Rose is the 1 with Butler as the 2. Gibson is the 4 with Gasol at the 5. And it's Miritich in the 3 slot. For a franchise that had so much success under his tenure, there was sure a lot of friction with Tom Thibodeau, and the Bulls front office surprised a lot of people, I know, including yourself.
Yeah, you know, it's not something that you see often, a winning coach at odds with his GM and president. With how often their differences came up, though, you knew something was afoot.
In a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for Cleveland.
Tell you what, guys, They're showing us a lot of energy early on and racking up those fast break points.
And also, they're jumping on a lot of turnovers, making sure they turn them into points at the other end.
Jones checked in for Martin Chumper. Three-pointer, Dellavedova. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Williams.
And with Thibs, he did end up getting fired from the Bulls this past season. Some saw it coming, but still, I think surprising given the level of success he had. His imprint is all over this Bulls team and the way they approach the game.
Pass to Jones. Ball's knocked loose. Stolen by Rose. Here's Mirotić. The rim-rattling two-handed jam.
And guys, that's a big swing right there. I mean, taking the steal and then turning it into two easy points on the dunk.
No telling how important that sequence could turn out to be.
And guys, in a game this snug, moments like that are the ones we usually look back on at the end as a difference maker.
Catching up on the changes for Cleveland. Mozgov comes in for Thompson. And Jefferson subbed in for Williams. Butler.
Jimmy Butler.
And he comes off the screen and slams it through.
And, you know, that's an example of how many plays we have in a game for which there's no stat. A monster dunk coming off just a terrific pick play.
Greg, you're right. It really did work to perfection. Gave him all the room he needed for the play.
Boy, that's a sound physical play. I mean, you can't be afraid to put a shoulder into somebody every once in a while. It's a contact sport, folks. And when you look at how Thibs got fired, I mean, there are a lot of reasons why a coach can be let go. I mean, he didn't have any performance issues, but apparently clashed in some form or fashion with the front office. Sometimes that's all it takes to be asked to go somewhere else.
The shot's good from Gasol.
He got a great read of where that miss was going, and that allowed him to be the first guy to it and get the putback.
It's stolen by Rhodes. Here's Butler, and he takes that one up and powers it through.
And that's how you make a steal count. Turn it into a quick slam at the other end.
It was really a case. It looked like Greg Anthony right there, but if I can say so. It was really a case of a great defensive play triggering some instant offense.
Yeah, I remember GA as an irritant, and this guy, much like Greg, creating havoc out there.
And the Cavaliers call time here.
And guys, the first year for David Blatt, he was second guessed at every turn. And that happens when you are picked to make the finals, but also when you coach LeBron James.
Looking at who's out there now for the Cavaliers. James checked in for Love. Amon Shumpert is coming for James Jones. J.R. Smith's checked in for Jefferson. And Irving subbed in for Matthew Dellavedova.
The D just sagged off just enough and no hesitation on his part.
And for Black, Greg, everyone did wonder if he would be the right fit early. As the season wore on, the Cavs got tougher. Those questions, Clark, went away.
Yeah, and I think most people forget that he's an iconic coaching legend overseas.
Good point, yeah.
So coaching is coaching. Sure, it's not the NBA, but this guy brought a pedigree and resume that was quite substantial.
Here's Portis. That drops and it comes off an assist from Brooks. And the Bulls lead by four.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference in points in the paint between the two teams.
Yeah, it's really been quite a contrast. I like the way they're attacking the middle at their offensive end.
McDermott can't get it to go. Last game for the Bulls, it was a loss to the Brooklyn Nets.
And boy, that was a tough one to lose, guys. But they played well throughout that game, just unable to convert down the stretch.
Yeah, I know we don't get into moral victories, but they can definitely take away some positives from it, because even though they came up on the short end, there was some good stuff, too.
The drive by Brooks. Outside Gibson.
I tell you what, he has gone stone cold here to start this quarter.
And there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting two.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
Yeah, the officials didn't need to talk that one over. It was obvious.
J.R. Smith hits them both.
Thank you, Cleveland!
The Bulls have gone 7 of 11 from the field in the second quarter. Over to the wing. Mirotić dishes to Rose. No good trying to beat the buzzer. And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. Welcome back, everyone. The second half about to get underway, and it's been a close one so far. We are seeing a tremendous game from Jimmy Butler.
And the thing I noticed most in that first half was his offense. He was not wasteful with his opportunities and also did a great job of converting with the chances he had.
I agree with you, Greg. Judicious shot selection. All of his looks were good looks.
Here we go now, the start of the third quarter, welcoming you back in a closely contested first half so far. We are seeing a tremendous game from Jimmy Butler.
That slasher mentality was on display in that first half. He got to the rim consistently.
Boy, I tell you what, he's got that great first step, and he must have had some quickness porridge or something because he looks a little faster today than normal.
Kyrie Irving and J.R. Smith at the guard set. Down low, it's Love and Mozgov. And it's James in at the small forward position. That's the group starting the second half for David Blatt. And Mirotić kicks to Butler. Six to shoot. Oh, yes, he did. Five up and five down for him so far.
Cavaliers. You know, of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is major smash-mouth basketball, guys.
It's all about imposing your will offensively, getting exactly the kind of looks their coach drew up.
Timeout called, Cleveland. Cavs were poised to make a huge run last year in the playoffs, swept the Celtics in the first round, but it cost them.
Yeah, and even though they did get that sweep, they lose Kevin Love for the rest of the way, and that put a big hurdle in their quest for the title.
Shumpert is checked in for the Cavaliers.
A slight advantage for them in the rebound department, but that oftentimes is all it takes.
Especially, Greg, when you're scoring the ball at a decent clip the way they have. I mean, they... Forget about going for the long-range bomb to cut into that lead. Just take it to the hoop, my friend. Take it to the hoop.
And how, Clark. Brilliant throwdown.
Just exerting his authority on that play.
And James throws it down.
You know, no time wasted getting that ball up the floor for the uncontested finish.
The pass to Gibson. Butler on the wing. Feeds it to Mirotić. Back to Butler. Outside Gibson. The Bulls need to get a shot off here. Rose attacking. Rose back up. And stolen by Kyrie Irving. And LeBron throws it down hard.
I don't know that this is the time for that kind of flair. In a close game, the important thing is the 2 points, not the dramatics.
Oh, come on, Clark. He had to go for it, didn't he?
Yeah, perhaps. But hey. He's an athlete, and I can't fault him for that one. Although, if he missed it, I might have.
A different look now for Cleveland. Thompson, he's checked in for Mozgov. Jefferson comes in for Smith. And it's Matthew Dellavedova in for Irving. So Chicago going with an almost entirely new group. Portis, he's checked in for Gibson. Doug McDermott comes in for Mirotić. Kirk Heinrich, he's checked in for Jimmy Butler. And Brooks subbed in for Rose. Chicago making a switch here. Bairstow's checked in. LeBron right side. They get the rebound. Thompson passes to Dellavedova, and he misses the go-ahead basket. Chicago leading. There's the steal. Now Cleveland moving it up. It's good. This game is all even. Dellavedova's got 8 points.
And how about that one man fast break?
I love the power finish at the end of it, too.
And the basket good.
You got to love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of grinded out physical game.
That's the kind of look they can continue to go with. Maybe that'll help them create some separation on the scoreboard.
Excellent ball movement there, guys.
And that's keyed this run, passing it with purpose. The D hasn't been able to keep up.
And Cleveland making a change here. Williams has checked in. And a change for the Bulls. Snell's checked in. And Brooks, here we go. And that one is hammered home. This game has a lot of character here in the third period.
Yeah, you know what, guys? I love seeing this type of action. A competitive, compelling matchup. A lot of lead changes here so far.
Yeah, six already. Intensity is the theme for this one.
LeBron kicks to Williams. Good, and the assist goes to James. James has got 3 assists in the game.
You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist numbers. And theirs are fantastic.
Just beautiful when they play the game like this.
Snatched away. In transition, here comes...
Oh, wow!
It's a beautiful jam.
Talk about putting something extra on it. That dunk was way over the top.
Close game or not, Clark, you know, he's going to finish firm when he gets the space.
I'm startled that he would even try something like that at this stage of the game.
The Cavaliers shooting their 6th and 7th free throws in the game.
At the line for your Cavaliers.
And the first one drops. Bulls always seem to be tough on the road, and last season no different. They would end with 23 road wins on the year.
And that number was good enough for the second most in the East. Unlike shooting, it's very hard for defenses to go cold, and that's why the Bulls have been so good on the road.
Kevin Love's checked in for Richard Jefferson. He has a highlight reel unto himself, guys.
Yeah,
wow.
That could very well be a contender for Dunk of the Year, and perhaps... might make its way all over the internet.
I tell you what, that is the crowd pleaser of all crowd pleasers.
Williams kicks to Dellavedova. Stolen by Rose. Oh, and a fast break for the Bulls. And finished off by Miritic.
Yeah, how about the sharp steal and then run out? It looks like they're ready to put the hammer down.
Well, we've been waiting for one of these teams, Greg, to pull away. And as we finish the third quarter, it's still close. Both teams trading baskets. Cavaliers lead by 2. And we'll have the start of the fourth quarter for you as soon as we get back from this short break. All right, we welcome you back to what's been a hard-fought battle. Fourth quarter should be good. Cavaliers leading on the court for the Bulls, getting this fourth quarter started. Miritic is out there with Portis. And there's Etuan Moore. And it's McDermott. And it's Heinrich in at the 2 spot. That's good.
There's been a huge discrepancy between these teams and their effectiveness from the 3-point line.
It has been pronounced, no doubt about it. Definitely a big factor to this point in the game.
Shot clock at 6. Moore dishes to Miritic. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot 2. And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for the Cavaliers.
Guys, the passing we've seen from them has been tremendous. Very unselfish.
Yeah, but they've also done a great job of playing in space, getting out in transition every opportunity.
Mozgov, he's checked in for the Cavaliers. Cleveland moving it around. And he gets it to go. That's now 8 points for Smith.
You know, it's really hard not to notice the difference in the passing of these two teams today.
It's a stark discrepancy when you look at the assist columns and you see that difference as far as the fluidity in their respective offenses. Excellent work there in transition.
Yeah, I think it's always better to go early in transition, to attack when it's there, because oftentimes you can beat the defense down the floor.
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice steal, and then how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And Greg, nothing spurs some great offense like a play defensively.
That indicates the importance of great on-the-ball defense, as was displayed right there.
Heinrich with it. Now Smith defending. He held that one.
Confident and composed on the three-point shot at a critical juncture. Clutch.
The kick out to Irvin. For three, Love. Offensive rebound. And Smith. And a missed layup.
Oh, excellent interior D to force the miss.
His defensive ability is a big factor. I mean, there's no denying that. What a pass, and then the layup was a bit of a circus move.
Oh, so smooth.
Yeah, he really could have fouled that one up, trying for the big slam there, though. Just a nice, solid finish for the layup.
Timeout called, Cleveland.
Yeah, none too pleased with the play of his team, and you know what? They just need to get things sorted out.
Yeah, you know, there's not a coach around who would be happy with the way his guys have kind of rolled over during this run.
And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Well, over the break, I listened in on David Blatt's huddle. He told his guys, hey, we haven't been playing that well, and yet we're still in this thing. If we straighten up, put together a few buckets, we can seize control of this basketball game. Can they execute now, Kevin?
Thank you, Doris. Cleveland's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Gasol. Fourth quarter of play, and we're about 2.5 minutes through it right now. Irving kicks to Smith. He feeds it to LeBron. And Mirotić sends it back to the middle. Here's Rose. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. And that's 12 points for Rose.
Another bucket in the paint. That's something they just have not been able to stop today.
Yeah, the defense is all about disrupting timing and spacing, and what they've got going right now is not getting it done.
Irving attacking. Smith outside. Once again off the mark by Cleveland. Here's Chicago. 9 points in a row. Good run for him right now. Butler with the ball. He's picked up by James. Here's Mirotić. It's Chicago with another bucket.
And some kind of switch must have been flipped at halftime, because both teams are getting after it.
Man, I tell you, partner, this has been some fun basketball, and they don't look like they're slowing down at all. You better strap your seatbelt on here.
And the Cavaliers call time here. They're losing by 4. We've got 1:48 left to play in the final quarter. We've got 1:48 left in the game. And the dunk by James.
Explosive leaping ability.
Oh, that was pretty. And he just has that part, that effortless knack for getting inside.
Mm-hmm. And guys, how about how fearsome he is at times? I mean, you'd hate to be the guy tasked with guarding him.
James, the three-pointer. LeBron's got 16 here in the second half.
And he's showing signs now of life after going scoreless through the half.
And Gasol slams it in.
And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the deep.
Look at that.
Man, he got fancy with that one, didn't he?
Yeah, maybe trying to give them the momentum boost they need to break this game open.
I tell you what, I like that, though, guys. Some coaches might not want you to make a play like that, but I tell you what, when you got the skills like that, I say go for it.
Cleveland moving the ball around. Here's Shumpert. good, and the assist goes to Irving. That's 10 points for Amon Shumpert. So the whistle blows on the shot, and two free throws for the contact right there. He drops the first one, and that narrows the gap to one. Love check in for Cleveland. He's off on the free throw, unable to get that second one to drop in. It's tipped. And here's the fast break. Here's Gibson. And the rejection by Love. Here's James. And counting. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today.
Of course, he didn't have an attempt there in the first half. He's hoping to be a little bit more active and aggressive here and draw some fouls here in the second.
And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
Now, how did he manage to change his shot midair?
34 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Rose passes to Butler. And again, Chicago, no good.
It's a clear look at the hoop. He doesn't miss many of those.
Right wing for three, Love. Another three for Cleveland.
That one will seal the deal there. They've exploded here at the end.
Boy, I love the serious killer instinct they've shown. Finishing strong.
It really does make the game easy for your teammates when you can lead them to the rim that well with a pass.
Irving dishes to Love. Back to Irving. And so it's Cleveland winning this one. A confident win and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
They certainly put on a good show here at home, and I think they felt they had the edge and that extra little bit of confidence.
Well, folks, that's going to do it for now. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in. And we send you now over to Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kenny the Jet Smith.